Today on Free Per View, it's the Melee from L.A. with the two undisputed queens of comedy, Carol the Burner Burnett and Betty the Whip White, fight it out for the title with the absence of any involvement by Don King. Let's get ready to rumble as we start the Family Feud Special with the star of Family Feud, Richard Dawson.
How did that come? I knew you'd come crawling back. All right. Thank you. Oh, yeah. Winning money, are we? Thanks for being here. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. In the 9 years that I did it before I ever came back, and all the shows we've done since, never had a week of specials like we've had right this week. This is so, if you can imagine, you know when you were young and if you were a girl, there was a boy that you always wanted to date, or a girl, and suddenly that person agreed to go out on a date, usually you were a little bit disappointed. And occasionally, it was just even more magical than you could ever think. You're looking at it right here, because these ladies and their friends have brought. You're wonderful. Sweet Betty and Carol. I love you. How much have you won, my angel?
We have.
$16,000.
I'm very proud of
you. Yes, yes.
Hereditary Disease Foundation.
Or the Hereditary Disease Foundation. Yes,
exactly.
Indeed. Mm-hmm. The gang.
The gang play.
Okay, this is my adored and adorable daughter, Carrie.
Hi, Carrie.
And her husband, Mark, the son, whom I now have.
Ah, how nice.
And Mark's mom, Dahlia, who is my new sister.
What a classy introduction. Wonderful. Thank you. That's very nice.
Hello.
Does Mom have writers? These are great introductions.
I think she's quite good. She might take your guys' place here.
Yeah?
They were talking about it.
Yeah.
Carrie and Mark married right on this stage. 3.5 months ago, right here. This is where they did every wonderful Carol Burnett show. Studio...
33.
You can't get luckier than that. I like the suit. You told me you were going to dress.
Well, they let me hold the money, and
I love it. Thank you for being here.
Thank you.
Have fun.
For having us. It
was my pleasure. Sweet Betty and her friends, winners of $11,000.
Yes.
My heart rests a little easier when you both have some money.
Oh, thank you, Betty.
$11,000. What charity will you play for in this game?
In this game, Morris Animal Foundation, headquartered in Denver. It's an animal health organization.
You know it. If it's animal and Betty's for it, it's good, right?
Yes.
All right. May I meet your friends, please?
They're my very good friends after yesterday's
game. That's what I said.
Henry Pollack, Roman numeral II, Henry Pollack II.
Oh, Henry.
Hello.
Brenda Thompson.
Hello.
And Tony Pandolfo, actor of excellence. And they're part of our Pico Poker Club. We play poker about every 4 weeks.
You got the cup?
Cup, you have the cup.
Yes, the cup. And whoever wins for the evening
takes this home,
and you have to remember to bring it back the next day, or else it's $2,000 or death.
Oh.
Yeah, we play for about $4, but...
It's the principle of the thing.
It's the principle of the thing.
Who ordered the
pen? No.
All right, thanks for being here. We're going to have fun.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Played an excellent game.
Thank you.
Fast money.
Even after the bathtub.
You showed me a little more than I cared, but you're wonderful. Thank you. Sweet Tony.
Thank you.
Let's do it again now.
Okay.
$5,000. $5,000. Tell them we'll play the bankroll game. I hope you realize you kept Miss Burnett and myself waiting.
I know it, and she doesn't have all that kind of time.
Oh, get it. $5,000, the very least.
Was it supposed to be
anybody you like for bankroll? We don't mind.
Okay.
You like playing, don't you?
I love I love playing.
Yeah, you don't mind Betty being here, do you?
Do I mind Betty being here? Betty who?
I asked you first. Betty.
Love that, Betty.
$5,000, very least you're playing fast money. Could be as much as $14,000. This is worth $1,000. Looking for the number one bankroll answer. Tell me something about which people say the more you get, the more you want. Yes.
Money.
Money. Money. Make sure bank $6,000. This is worth $3,000. Tell me something that's described as being floppy.
Yes.
Discs.
A floppy disk. Oh. Moving into the computer. $8,000, the very least you will play for. Our last bankroll question worth $5,000. Here it is. Tell me something that gets dumped.
Yeah. A boyfriend.
A boyfriend. No.
Well, you haven't been to my house.
Something that gets dumped.
Garbage.
Garbage. Garbage. Betty and the team will play for $6,000. Carol for $13,000. But first, they've got to win the game. We'll find out which one of these teams wins right after we watch this. Your obedient servant. Oh, you're fine. You're fine. 300 points to the magic score. Whichever team gets that will play for the money in the bank. 100 women were asked this question. Top six answers are on the board. Here's the question we asked the 100 women. Tell me something that puts you in a sexy mood.
Yes. Music.
Music. Music. Oh, yes. Good. I think your voice is starting to change.
I do, too.
Is it? We said to 100 women, tell me something to put you in a sexy mood. What do you think the ladies said, Henry?
I would think they would say alcohol or wine.
Oh, dear. Here he goes, right for the booze. Oh! I know Brenda. She doesn't run with that sort of drink.
Uh-huh.
What do you think the ladies said would put them in a sexy mood?
Candlelight.
I like that. A little candlelight. Yeah. And Tony?
A teddy or a lovely lingerie.
Oh, yes, okay. Good.
Lingerie.
Yes,
very nice. The answers left. They're playing our song. 100 women. Put in a sexy mood.
I think a sweet, warm kiss.
Okay. Oh. Hello? Oh, it's real, Henry.
Yeah, thank you.
Hello.
Sweet, warm kiss! Whoa! Henry, we can polish this off. 100 women. What puts you in a sexy mood?
Would a aromatic massage be the same as touching?
I'll find out. What we call the AM, aromatic massage?
You know, like aromatic or not, it would be the same.
Similario. Similario.
Okay, similario. Then I would say a hot partner.
You know, something.
No, I agree, absolutely. I found dead people are. They could no more put you in a sexy mood than fly. Uh-huh. A hot partner.
Oh.
First strike. Brenda, why does he always bury
his head? I know, it's just awful.
Something puts you in a sexy mood.
A romantic dinner?
Let's see. We'd love a romantic dinner. Oh, two strikes, Tony.
A romantic movie. A movie.
Okay, fine. Weekend at Bernie's 2. A movie? We'll be back right after this. Da-da-da-da. Did you have a movie? Did you have a movie?
I said...
Some departing contestants will receive
Advanced Formula Centrum, with more vitamins and minerals than any leading brand. Centrum, more complete from A to Zinc, more important than ever. If you suffer from cold sores, sun, and fever blisters, treat, protect, and help prevent them with Herpesin L. Herpesin L's unique non-drying formula quickly heals cold sores. Herpesin L at drugstores everywhere. New Tyson chicken pies. Tender white meat chicken, crisp garden vegetables, and a rich, creamy sauce. All surrounded by a flaky pastry crust.
You got it. 7-6. Every time I always say you got to get on the board, you do that.
Okay.
Point values are doubled. 100 people surveyed. Top 6 answers on the board. Here's the question. If you could teach your spouse one of the commands you taught your dog, which one would it be?
Yeah. Stay.
Stay. You're the lover of dog. Henry. What command?
Fetch.
Fetch. Barry? I mean, he got number one. That's a great answer. Mark just beamed. Well, they're newlyweds. Characters stay. That's lovely. What command would you teach your spouse?
Roll over.
Oh. Roll over! Yeah. Oh, I love this lady. Heel!
Too nasty.
Dances to a different drummer there. If you could teach your spouse one of the commands that you've taught your dog, which one would it be?
Come.
Okay. Come! Different reading. You see how long it took before? Because they want me to say it again. Well, I won't. I won't. I won't pander to this. I forgot it was him.
Yeah. Do ask the question.
I will. If you could teach your spouse one of the commands that you've taught your dog, which one would it be? And remember, heel and has been already said.
Well, sit.
Why not? Sit!
No!
Oh, 92 up there. What do you think? Don't whisper. Don't whisper. They're set out there.
Be quiet.
It's my job to come up.
Okay.
What is it?
Get the paper.
All right. That would be fetching.
Okay. Be quiet.
Okay. I love it when you're strict. Be quiet. Say we got a good even game. If not a big lead for Sweet Betty. Be quiet. Six. Five. 120-76. Let's go. Marco. That's the Valentine's card. Stage. Mm-hmm. Point values are tripled. 100 people surveyed. Top 5 answers on the board. Here's the question. Who would you never want to see the results of your IQ test?
Yeah. Your boss.
Your boss! Yeah. One answer will beat it. Someone you never want to see the results of your IQ test.
My spouse.
Spouse! Oh, good, good. Well done. And someone that you'd never ever want to see the results of your IQ test.
Your kids.
We want them. Perfect.
Don't want the kids to see. 49, 2 answers left. Betty?
Your mother.
Uh-huh. Mom? Mom! Always say mom and you'll never get a shot. Henry?
Your teacher.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, okay. Well, because the teacher would feel like a failure, I guess. If it's there, okay. If not, first strike. Teacher! Oh. First strike, okay. If you get this, you'll play for the big money here.
I know.
Would you never want to see the results of your IQ test?
Yowza, my ex-husband. I don't know.
Have we got that?
Sorry.
No, ex, we don't have an ex, do we? No.
It's probably a shame, but
we'll take a look.
Is.
either Henry Kissinger or ex-husband. No.
Well, I have two choices. Okay. Your best friend.
Right. Take a look. If it's there, you'll play for the big money. If not, get ready to steal Tony's very best friend. No. Boy, oh boy. How can it be? Someone you'd never, ever want to see the results of your IQ test. Just a tribute to All Quiet on the Western Front. BUZZR went, and I'll need an answer.
Oh, gosh. The IRS.
Yeah. Is that it? IRS?
It's probably up there.
If it's there, my angel, you'll play for the money. If not, you're going to like the IRS. like a banjo. Two people. Yes? It's Henry. We bring up $6,000. Right after we watch this. Oh, 20 seconds on the clock. Okay. Time will start, my love, when I finish reading the first question. We wish you luck.
Thank you.
Name something people have to be taught to hold correctly.
Fork.
Exactly what temperature is room temperature?
78 degrees.
A way you stop a person from snoring.
Turn them over.
Something you buy to keep you warm.
A coat.
Something you need to go water skiing.
Skis.
See, that's the epidemic. That's what's been getting me in trouble. I've nearly drowned on 5 occasions. Skis, of course, what a fool. I've just been drank. Well, I don't even want to talk about it. Something people have to be taught to hold correctly. A fork. Survey. 26.
Oh, good job.
Exactly what temperature is room temperature? And of course, you gave me Jimmy Carter's favorite. 78 degrees. Survey.
Oh.
No.
A little warm.
He used to like it crisp. And that away, you stop a person from snoring, and you said kill them. Oh, no, you said, I'm sorry.
That's my first choice.
Turn them over. Survey said, yeah, we got 71. Then you buy to keep you warm, and you said, coat. Survey said, oh, yeah. Then you need to go water skiing, and am I a fool? You said skis. Survey said, what a plan. This is wonderful. 48 points. Yay, yay, yay.
Okay.
I'm going to be very good.
Okay. I want steroid testing right after this show.
Not a drug has passed through.
Not at all. I know that. Get high on people. He was arrested yesterday in possession of a quartet. 48 points. If you say any of the answers that Brenda gave, you'll hear this. Now say try again.
I love that suit.
Okay. Good plan. I want you to win that money, okay? 25 seconds, please. Thank you. Time will start when I finish reading the first question. Name something people have to be taught to hold correctly.
Their posture.
Exactly what temperature is room temperature?
68 degrees.
A way you stop a person from snoring.
Waking them up.
Something you buy to keep you warm.
A jacket. A blanket.
Okay. Something you need to go water skiing.
The skis.
Try again.
Trunks.
Trunks. Okay. Very sweet. Well, I loved it. Some people have to be taught to hold correctly. You said their posture. Survey said. Pen or pencil was number one. I remember the lessons I had. Exactly what temperature is room temperature? 72 was number one, you said?
68.
68. That's what Jimmy Carter loved. Survey? He did.
Okay.
Trying to save his energy. We are 35 points away. Way that you stop a person from snoring. Turn them over was number one, and you said, wake them up. You're snoring, you said. Survey? 19.
You got it.
Something you buy to keep you warm. Coat was number one, and you said?
Blanket.
A blanket. 16 points. Survey said?
Please.
Yes! Yes! And a boat. A boat you need for water skiing. Tomorrow, the last of our very special feuds. We love them. We love you. See you here tomorrow on The Feud.
Some departing contestants will receive.
Presenting panties that move with you, not on you. Panties that stay in place. Now there's a novel idea from Fruit of the Loom.
From Lee, salon-style press-on nails. Natural underside so real only your manicurist knows. Fashion colors plus extra-strength glue. Lee press-on nails, salon-style.
Relief for an irritated nose. Lee Knows Better Spray with moisturizing glycerin without addictive drugs and Knows Better Gel with soothing vapors. Lee Knows Better.
This is Gene Woods speaking for Family Feud. A Mark Goodson television production.
Are you watching, you little rascals?
Oh, it's fun, isn't it?
And who subscribes to it?
Go on. Push the button.
Think of the fun you could have on
the tube.
The tube.
You.
Tube.
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 TV tubes.
That's a lot of fun, isn't it?
It's gonna be a lot more fun
if you keep going the way you're going.
Go on. Push the button.
Please subscribe. Subscribe.
I hope they're watching.